You have up to 5 minutes, Kate.
I've spoken to you before on the matter of Friern Barnet Library. You listened carefully and well to what I had to say, and I hope you'll do so again tonight. I told you that as a conservative, I believed in conserving all that was good in our society, and I wish to conserve the much loved and only community building left in Friern Barnet. Sadly, my wishes weren't granted, and it was a very sorry day in my life last April when the library closed. But there was a little light for me. I was going to be provided with a smaller but functioning library in the Arts Depot until the all-singing, all-dancing new landmark library was ready at the Arts Depot. So today, I went on a mission. I decided to visit this library, and I will now describe my trip. For the purposes of this visitation, I imagined fondly that it was 25 years ago. So I staggered up Friern Barnet Lane with my toddler in a buggy and my other two children coming on. It began to rain. I reached Friern Barnet Road. In the old days, I would now be at the library, going in, getting myself dry, children happily racing around the bookshelves and reading books. We would choose our books, we'd probably visit local shops, talk to the local economy, and make our way home. But now, I'm waiting for a bus. The family Salinger eventually struggled into the bus and alighted tally-ho. We eventually crossed the road and entered the Arts Depot. Over the foyer, into the lift, onto the second floor. Out of the lift, cross over the cafe area, into another lift, and up to the fourth floor. We found the library, one little room in the rafters, and I describe it as a paltry sop to the people of Friern Barnet. Nothing more. When I consider how close this little room is to the North Finchley Library, I wonder that anyone at all visits it. And certainly no one else was there when I was today. And talking to the library staff, the one person who was there, I don't think there are many others at any other times of the day. And why would you? If you've got as far as there, you just pull further up the road and go to North Finchley, which is a proper library. Now, I must be in cloud cuckoo land. I fondly imagine that when Friern Barnet Library and North Finchley were going to merge into this wonderful library at the Arts Depot, they would close at approximately the same time. How wrong I was. I imagined that the Arts Depot landmark library would rise phoenix-like out of the ashes to show the rest of the borough what a proper library would be like. Cuckoo I am. Friern Barnet closed, North Finchley still open, and apparently will be so for at least another 18 months. And all Friern Barnet Library has is a garret. The room in the Arts Depot is certainly not a library. I think I possess more books in my house than are there. There are no newspapers, there are no computers, there's no reading area, it's a few children's books. To describe it as a library is doing the word library an injustice. It's only open on 4 days a week, and only for 3 hours a day. But as I said anyway, who bothered to go there when they only had to go up the road to go to a proper library? In my opinion, it's a waste of £34,000 a year, or however much the rent is, and however much it costs for the one librarian sent from North Finchley or Finchley Central to run it. It's a sop that is a complete waste of money. May I remind this committee that 2,500 people have already signed a petition asking the cabinet member to reconsider his decision concerning the Friern Barnet Library. May I beg you to use your muscle and persuade the cabinet member to do so. Open up our library, residents will run it. There are lots of schemes out there, lots of people had ideas. I believe in help. The amount of rent currently being paid to the Arts Depot for the attic could be given as a grant to the residents of Friern Barnet who want to run their own library. This would probably cost even less than that rent. I wasn't aware that the Antigone suburb had been given their utilities bills as well as it is £25,500. So, you know, I think a bit of parity in that direction would go down rather well.
Thank you very much, Councillor Salinger.